Taurus, you are up for the September tarot energy reading. Before I go any further, KIRWKC.com, main podcasting platform. This podcast is carried on Apple, Spotify, Google, iHeartRadio, Pandora, Overcast, Bullhorn, Amazon Music, Audible, and several other podcasting platforms. Please feel free to listen to this podcast on whatever platform is most convenient for you. KIRWKC on all the social media platforms. Okay, so we're in August right now. All of the August readings are up. So the general reading is up, the love reading is up, the money reading is up for all of the signs. The full moon in Aquarius reading for the collective is up, and the Lionsgate reading for the collective is also up. Whatever reading you listen to or watch, take what resonates, leave what doesn't. If it's not your story, don't try to make it fit. I'm just a person sitting here reading the energy and the tarot cards. You know your story better than I ever could. Now that I've said all that, let's hop into the reading. I'm using my karma cards, and then I'll go to my tarot deck. May I have the energy for Taurus for September? May I have the energy for Taurus for September? May I have the energy for Taurus for September? What is it that Taurus needs to hear? What is it that Taurus needs to hear? What is it that Taurus needs to hear? May I have some cards, please? That was a little too many. I'm going to take these. Oh, it was two cards. I thought it was more than that. Okay. So, what do we... That keeps coming out a lot. This one has not come out yet. Interesting. Okay. Lots of houses here, Taurus. Okay, at the bottom of the deck is in the ninth house. It says, as if it or they came from all there is. The philosophies and laws involved. Do it in a big way. So, in the ninth house, at the bottom of the deck. Now, this one has been coming out a lot. In the 10th house, responsibly, success, become a person of power and status. Become a person of power and status. I mean, Taurus is Empress energy. Power, the Empress has power and status. Just saying. Doesn't matter if you're male or female. There's no gender in tarot. So, yeah. And then... The third card in the seventh house, diplomatically, relationships, get a fair deal. So there may be some negotiating going on where you're trying to get a good deal. Again, take what resonates, leave what doesn't. Okay, these cards just fell down. I'm not going to take them, but I will say what they are. So we have Strength, Knight of Wands, and the Page of Wands. Definitely movement and messages. Some of you may be dealing with some travel. Maybe some of you are looking to get a good deal on traveling as well. And all of that was fire energy. Maybe some of you are in the midst of traveling in the month of August. If you're watching this in September, maybe you have already traveled a lot recently. But honestly, I feel like some of you may be looking for a good deal on some travel. Again, take what resonates, leave what doesn't. May I have the energy for Taurus for September? May I have the energy for Taurus for September? May I have the energy for Taurus for September? What is it that Taurus needs to hear? What is it that Taurus needs to hear? What is it that Taurus needs to hear. Also, so random. I heard something about a grand opening. I think it's because of how this looks in this picture. Where is people shaking? You know how when someone cuts the ribbon at something or whatever, and then they're shaking hands, or either they have the shovel and then they do the first shovel of starting a construction project or whatever, those types of things. I don't know why. Is somebody opening a store, like a physical store, not an online store, like a grand opening of a store or something like that? Something dealing with the physical building is what I'm talking about. Maybe that might be the good deal too. You're trying to get a good deal on the rent for the building. Like, because with commercial real estate, I'm pretty sure, you know, people are negotiating right now because it's not making the money it once made due to the economy and everything else. Maybe you're finding a good deal, or you're looking for a good deal on a building to start an actual storefront business and do that. Again, take what resonates, leave what doesn't. And I feel like somebody might be doing a grand opening or something. May I have some cards, please? Okay. All of these came out. I have 2 fours, a 9, and the world. Definitely some traveling going on. First card that came out is 4 of Cups, which is fire energy. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. This is about a solid foundation, is what this is about. It can also be about an upgrade too, as well. It can be about recognition. It can be about celebration. 4 of Cups, another 4, can be about being complacent and ignoring an offer that is being made to you by the universe. That might be going on. This is making me think of that building where they're saying, we want to give you this building for X amount. And you're like, no, I don't like that. But at the same time, you're still looking for a building. And again, take what resonates, leave what doesn't. If that isn't your timeline, then this is just an offer being made of stability. You're rejecting it. This person is in their energy like, my goodness, Taurus isn't open to it. And they're in that 9 of Swords energy. You could be dealing with an air sign, Aquarius, Libra, Gemini. World card here about recognition and moving on from a cycle. Some of you might be leaving some people behind or a person behind in doing that, where they're offering to be part of your life, but you're stable on your own. 4 of Wands. Again, take what resonates, leave what doesn't. But really, I feel that you're looking to get the right deal. Because I'm looking at this 4 of Cups, I'm looking at this 9 of Swords, and the world. There's an opportunity to close something out and start a new cycle, but it has to be the right offer. Some of you might want to reconsider the offer because you may be thinking that they're not giving you a fair deal, but they really are. What's at the bottom? I didn't even check the bottom of the deck. Yeah, Hangman energy is stuck. It can also deal with sacrifice and enlightenment. Also, this is Pisces energy. I'll take another card. That almost came out. That's the 2 of Cups. That's trying to come out. Yeah. If I were you, whatever this is, just take another look at it. I'm not saying take it. I mean, we all have free will. You can do what you want to do. You may feel like this isn't it, but really it might be. Take a second look at the offer. What's at the bottom of the deck? The 9 of Cups. Yeah, another offer card. take a second look at the offer. Whatever this offer is, if it's about this building that I'm in regards to a business, so be it. If it's about a relationship, so be it. Whatever this offer is, take a second look at it. But I feel strongly that this is about some type of business or something involving a physical building that you are looking to invest in. Take what resonates, leave what doesn't. KIRWKC.com, main podcasting platform. This podcast is carried on Apple, Spotify, Google, iHeartRadio, Pandora, Overcast, Bullhorn, Amazon Music, Audible, and several other podcasting platforms. Please feel free to listen to this podcast on whatever platform is most convenient for you. KIRWKC on all the social media platforms. Until next time, Taurus, be blessed.